When I first read the script, I was thinking, oh my God, how are we possibly gonna shoot a dog party?
You can't just get 100 dogs and come in, sit, and bark on cue. You're working with animals.
My boy, Topaz!
And when an animal has decided they're done for the day, they're done for the day.
The story of Marmaduke really is one in which you have this teenage dog. He recently had a growth spurt, and he's kind of awkward, and he doesn't really fit in anywhere.
Marmaduke, no!
Family moves from Kansas to the OC.
Oh man, is life gonna change?
He thinks he's gonna get a chance to reinvent himself, gets to the dog park.
And there he comes in contact with a group of inn dogs known as the Pedigrees.
This is my park, and these are my rules. Now you look at my girlfriend again and you're dead. You come near her, you're dead. You talk to her and you're dead.
He thinks, well, you know, really to fit in, I need to impress the Pedigrees. I need to impress this girl.
Hit it, boys!
And so the story is about how he goes about doing that.
Oh, it's beautiful.
He learns some very valuable lessons about what it means to try to fit in with a crowd and the cost of what it entails to your family and to your friends.
You think he'll be okay here alone? I mean, what's the worst that can happen? He has a party, invites his girlfriend over?
Yes, and yes. Woo! The party scene, the Duke Rave, was the most challenging scene in the film because of the sheer scale of it.
I am a golden dog! Ain't I love?
We had to have an enormous amount of dogs. All of the main characters were in this scene.
And it's not just any party, it's a big Orange County rager. Orange County's a great big suburb. And what do kids do down there? They have house parties. Kids come over, or in this case, dogs, and they just trash the place.
Oh, not the stereo!
The party scene really represents the moment where he's really accepted.
We're not worthy! We're not worthy! We love you, man!
We had to achieve something that nobody had seen before.
It's gotta look big, which is the big thing.
And in order to pull that off, you have to have a lot of dogs.
Let the dogs out!
You have to also have the dogs behaving in such a way that makes you really believe these are teenagers.
Chug it, Chester!
Chug, chug!
Ow!
Sorry, slipped off the seat again!
And so we had to look at those things that are iconic to parties. The loud music, the dancing.
Nice lampshade, Bernie!
And try to figure out how do you translate those to dog behavior.
Whoa, whoa, no! Oh, hey! Not on the couch! You raising a barn?
It's more than just them doing a behavior. They have to do it with emotion, and they have to do it as an actor would do it.
It's so soothing!
It sounded really fun on the page, but when you get to the reality of it, it's very difficult.
The movie wouldn't be as great without this being the ultimate party sequence.
If the scene doesn't feel real, if you don't really believe that these dogs are having this big party and they're partying really hard and they're having the time of their life, it can make or break the movie. The jokes aren't gonna be as funny. And then the pathos that follows it is not gonna be anywhere near as emotional.
It's very complicated. How do you do a scene like this? Well, first of all, once we figured out we're gonna do this incredible party sequence, then we had to populate it with the kind of people you would see at a party. But, you know, dogs.
One of the most difficult parts is the casting process. Everybody's got so many different ideas. What kind of dog is this gonna be? What should this dog look like?
The casting process is critical because every single thing that a dog does in the scene is a trained action. If you don't get the right dogs, you're not gonna achieve the reality that you need for the scene. And so we work with the trainers and figure out, okay, well, what can a dog do and what would be fun to put into that party scene?
Our beagles were very good about standing up and then all of a sudden, as if they were getting shot by magic bullets, would faint.
All right, now it's a party.
Some dogs were picking up very quickly the actions that we needed, and some dogs, you know, took a lot longer.
They wanted a dog scratching a record, so we taught the dogs to do that, to put their feet up there and move it back and forth.
One of the trainers said, well, I can get my dog to wipe its rear end on the carpet, and so that dog had the gig.
It's a lot of time, very meticulous training, teaching each one of those pieces very specifically.
Every single dog that's in a shot is looking at a treat, and so probably the most challenging thing for me as a director on this film was how do you achieve performance from a dog that's staring at a chicken square? So it comes down to this entire production would be completely useless without, like, a chicken square. One of my favorite moments in the scene is the wide shot where you have 100 dogs around the pool. In order to do a shot like that, it took something like 15 hours to shoot.
You can't just put a lot of dogs in one place without them starting to get into a fight, so we have to work in very small groups.
And so what you do is you choose your frame, you lock it off, and then you can shoot one group at a time.
We would move those dogs out of the shot and bring in other dogs until you've got this mosaic of over 100 dogs.
If anyone touches a camera, we basically have to start over. Even little things like reloading the camera has to be done with absolute care and precision. If we move the camera, if it rotates a little bit like that, we could be in a very, very bad place.
Jump, 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 jump!
Probably the hardest shot in the scene is the dog jumping off the pool house.
I am a golden dog!
And the screenwriters came up with this idea of doing an homage to the scene in Almost Famous where he's on top of the roof and he's just addressing this huge crowd and they're all saying, jump, jump.
One of the things that made it challenging is the pool house was actually too tall and too far away from the pool for the dog to really jump off of there. So we needed a little bit of help with visual effects.
The limitation that we have is this dog can really only jump into the pool from a height of 5 feet. So what we have to do is we have to shoot the dog on a green screen stage on top of the 12-foot high roof. Then we cut it to what we're shooting right now, which is a kind of a wide shot of the dog finishing the drop and landing in the pool.
Clyde was actually one of the dogs we used in the movie Marley and Me, and he's a pretty wild dog. He's a lot of fun, he's got lots of energy, and you can't keep him out of the water.
Is it true, Marmaduke?
Only most of it.
You see, in the end, pedigrees always win.
There's two things going on with the scene. There's the sheer scale of it and how believable it's gonna be, but there's also the emotional content of it. And so if you don't have the emotion, it doesn't matter how big the scene is gonna be.
He's really keen on finally trying to fit in. So the party sequence has both pathos and humor and a lot of the emotions.
What have I done?
Once everything was shot, then we really had to start the whole process of making the dogs talk.
You're a big hit, Marmaduke.
We had to figure out how to convey with each line, whether it's a joke or whether it's something that's emotional.
We start with what was shot on location, and then we track it so that it follows where the actual dog is. Next, the animators will start to move the mouth and the eyes, and that's where the personality starts to come into play.
Hey, is it just me, or is it getting a little out of hand?
We had to figure out, okay, what are the facial expressions that each character is gonna have?
Do I know you from somewhere?
How wide does the mouth open? What do you do with the teeth?
Me? Nope, never seen you before.
We spent a lot of time working with them saying, okay, the brows should go up on and instead of but. It can make or break a shot if it's not all working in conjunction.
I recommend the guacamole, it's dynamite.
Jump, 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 jump.
I am a golden dog!
All right, now it's a party.
Yeah, come on. Who let the dogs out? Pee-wee, hit the crazy string. Hey, is this your party, dude?
Yeah.
We're not worthy. We're not worthy. We love you, man.
Everyone's having fun.
When you're watching the scene, you sort of forget that they're dogs. After a while, just understand them as characters.
They're not just talking dogs anymore. They really are actors.
Somehow that seems to happen. The dogs start to be the characters written for them in the script, and it's pretty amazing. It was definitely true on this movie.
It's really hard to do, and it takes a lot of patience. But I think with this scene, the audience is going to be taken somewhere where they've never been before, and they're going to experience something they've never seen before.
These animals are doing things you can't believe they're doing.